गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ विनय कुमार। यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट द चैप्टर ईश्वरन द स्टोरी टेलर इज कंटिन्यूड बाय मी। टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट वेयर यू हैड लर्नड आफ्टर दैट पैराग्राफ। फर्स्टली आई रेड आउट, then the words, difficult words which are prepared, then I will teach you. The place I come from is famous for timber, Ishwaran would begin. There is a richly wooded forest all around. The logs are hauled onto the lorries by elephants. They are huge well-fed beasts. When they turn wild, even the most experienced mahout is not able to control them. After this prologue, Ishwaran would launch into an elaborate anecdote involving an elephant. One day, a tusker escaped from the timber yard and began to roam about, stamping on bushes, tearing up wild creepers and breaking branches at will. You know, sir, how an elephant behaves when it goes mad. Ishwaran would get so caught up in the excitement of his own story that he would get up from the floor and jump about, stamping his feet in emulation of the mad elephant. The elephant reached the outskirts of our town, breaking the fences down like matchsticks, he would continue. It came into the main road and smashed all the stalls selling fruits, mud pots and clothes. People ran helter-skelter in panic. The elephant now entered a school ground where children were playing, breaking through the brick wall. All the boys ran into the classrooms and shut the doors tight. The beast grunted and wandered about, pulling out the football goalposts, tearing down the volleyball net, kicking and flattening the drum kept for water, and uprooting the shrubs. Meanwhile, all the teachers had climbed up to the terrace of the school building. From there, they helplessly watched the depredations of the elephant. There was not a soul below on the ground. The streets were empty, as if the inhabitants of the entire town had suddenly disappeared. Now I come to the difficult words. Timber means wood, begin means start, famous means fame, richly means dense, hauled means loaded, well-fed means strong, beasts means wild animals, experienced means skilled, control means to handle, prologue means introduction or preface, launch means start, elaborate means detailed, anecdote means short amusing story, timber yard means a yard where wood is stored. Stamping on means crushing. Creepers means a plant with long stems that grow along the ground. Emulation means copying something. Outskirts means out area or outer area of the town. Smashed means broke something noisily. Helter skelter means frightening. In panic means with fear. Terrace means roof. Depredation means plunder or damage. Disappeared means to be lost or vanished. Fence means wall. Flattening means leveling something. Entire means whole or total. Now, the place I come from is famous for timber. Ishwaran would begin. Now, Ishwaran, who was not only a storyteller, but also a cook of Mahindra, who was a supervisor or junior supervisor in the firm, he started to say that the place I come from is famous for timber. He said that he has been coming from the place. That place is famous for timber or wood. And there is a richly wooded forest all around. He further said that that place is richly wooded forest all around. The logs are hauled in that jungle. The logs are loaded onto the vehicles by elephants because they are huge well-fed beasts. Elephants are strong beasts. Further, he said about the elephants that when they turn wild, when the elephants became wild, even the most experienced mahout is not able to control them. The mahout who looks after the elephant, he is not able to control over elephants. After this prologue, after this preface, Ishwaran would launch, means Ishwaran started into an elaborate anecdote, means he started a detailed story related to elephant. It is a matter of one day. One day a tusker, tusker means a male elephant, escaped from the timber yard and began to, means he started to wander about. He was stamping on bushes, tearing up wild creepers and also breaking the branches according to his wish. With respectful, Ishwaran said to Mahindra that, you know, sir, how an elephant behaves when it goes mad. Ishwaran would get so caught up in the excitement, means Ishwaran would also involved, also indulge into the enthusiasm of his own story, and further he got up from the floor and jump about and also stamping his feet in emulation of the mad elephant. Means he also copying the activities of the mad elephant. Then further he said and continued that the elephant reached the outskirts, means outer area of the town, breaking the fences, means wall, into a small pieces, that is called like match sticks. Further, he also continued, it came into the main road. Then the elephant came into the main road and smashed, means crushed, all the stalls, means shops, the shops were selling fruits, mud pots and clothes also. Having seen this situation, people started to run with helter and skelter and also with fear. The elephant now entered a school ground. In that ground, children were playing, and in that school, the elephant broke through the brick wall. Having seen the elephant, all the boys who were playing in the campus of the school, they ran into the classrooms and closed their doors tightly. After then, the elephant started to make the sound and roaming about. He was also pulling out the football goalpost also tearing down the volleyball net and also kicking and flattening the drum, which drum was used to keep water, and also rooted out the shrubs. During this time also, all the teachers of the school climbed up to the terrace of the school building, and from that place they were helplessly watching the depredations of the elephant. There was not a soul, soul means here man, there was not a person below the ground, and the streets means main road was absolutely empty. The road appeared that there were not any inhabitants or not any dwellers who are present in the entire town, and they had disappeared this way. Means all the inhabitants of the streets were disappeared due to the activities of the elephants. Thank you for today. Be safe, be strong, be bold, and do your study well. Thank you for today. Next day I start further.